Hi, in this video, we'll be seeing about creation of simple interactive applications, that is the basics and certain advantages. So definition, if you see, an interactive application is a collection of objects intended for performing certain tasks when the user triggers a command. So this best example for interactive applications is all your video games. So when you trigger a command, it will be performing some task. So that is the definition that you can take. So non-interactive applications operate without human involvement. So for example, you can say compiler and batch processing applications are non-interactive applications. So compile is a program that converts the high-level programs to machine language. Similarly, so this doesn't need any human interaction. It will be done on its own. So it's called a non-interactive application. So similarly, batch processing is the execution of a series of jobs in the program on a computer without manual intervention. So interactive applications, they share application shares a graphical user interface. That because of this only, it becomes a GUI only, it becomes an interactive application. That is, you know, through GUI, the user can access the application dynamically. So interactive application, they consist of forms on which components such as button, text field, radio button, all these are present. So here one page may get linked with other pages dynamically also. So when, especially in the case of interactive web applications, this linking of the pages is done through hyperlinks, which you have experienced using your hyperlinks, you have experienced in the first unit. So this linking is based on the user input. So examples of interactive applications are like you can have your online user course registration, online shopping, etc. Now coming to the advantages of these applications. It increases the engagement of users in the collaborative productions. So if user is engaged, you can have collaborative productions. So instead of spending a lot of time on one-way presentation being shared across with a PowerPoint presentation, an interactive application allows the user to get engaged with the application. So user will get engaged with the application, it will have more, the user will be able to gain more knowledge. Okay, then here files can be early shared, accessed, edited and saved. Okay, so it boosts the communication, it increases the communication, and also information can be shared using email, print and files. So the intention of the user to handle that application can be identified by the interactive sessions that he makes with the application. So how many times you have gone and how many times you have done this, with all that, that is the intention of the user can be got from that, identified from that. So this helps in boosting the communication. So the documents can be annotated and effective changes can be made while handling the interactive applications. So here annotated means you can have some images stored along with that, or some short form indexing, or some names given to that, things like that. So the tools such as 3D modeling, hyperlinks, video links and other applications can be embedded within an interactive application. So the interconnectivity among the applications allows greater availability of the application to the user. Okay, so when it is user friendly, naturally the user will try to use that interactive application more. Okay, so users can connect to interactive applications using iOS or Android smart devices. So the information can be made available by using touchscreen technologies also. So when you, naturally when you have iOS or Android mobiles, you will be using touchscreen technologies. Using that, the user can give output and the application will be dynamically reacting according to the user's input. So now what happens, all these touchscreen technologies, this helps even an illiterate, this helps even an illiterate user to handle that application with ease and comfort.